Alright guys, so you could see this is a review video about this carbon racing windshield. This was probably pending since a long time. I actually didn't want to hurry up on the review since I wanted to test it thoroughly and then provide my feedback on this. So as you could already see, this windshield is removed from the bike. You would have guessed that there are some drawbacks which I wanted to talk mainly. So the review is mainly about that, to provide an insight on this windscreen. As you could see, this is a very broad windscreen which really does the job well on deflecting the wind, because it's so broad and it sits higher up on the bike, almost to this level. It's pretty good at deflecting the wind away from you. So it's a pretty good design in that front, but there is a major drawback with this screen. You know, since it's so broad, when you start increasing the speed, you know, like when you start going above 100, you feel the force of the wind. So it makes your front of the bike heavy, since it's broad, and the amount of force, you know, which is coming opposite, it's quite a lot at speeds above 100. So the bike tends to feel heavy on the front side, and also the performance of the bike drops at higher speeds. So if you are riding below 100, you wouldn't notice anything, but once you cross the 100 mark and you know you hit 120 or so kilometer per hour, you would start feeling it. So what happens mainly is at those speeds when you slow down, you know, all of a sudden the bike slows down immediately because of the force of the wind, which is sometimes dangerous when you are on the highway and you just want to reduce a bit, but the bike reduces a lot more than anticipated. And also this windscreen sits taller, and if you are shorter, it would, you know, obstruct your view. Though it is a very good design, I guess it is not so suitable for smaller capacity bikes, where on the higher speed the wind force is more, and you know, it would restrict certain things on the performance end also, because the thrust of the wind at those speeds are much higher. You know, if I would give an example, it's like, you know, you're walking on the land and walking inside the water. So when you're walking inside the water, you definitely use a lot of force is required than on walking on the land. Higher capacity bikes, you wouldn't notice this difference, since they have a good amount of torque and power, you know, to compensate this kind of loss. So the bikes like this, which are lighter and not that much powerful, would definitely feel the difference at higher speeds. It's better to go for a very aerodynamically designed, not much bigger windscreens on these kind of bikes. So rather than installing a huge amount of money on these kinds of big windscreens for smaller capacity bikes, I would suggest you invest that amount on a decent good helmet, which will reduce the wind noise and is very aerodynamic, and which will also increase your safety. So what kind of windscreens can you install then? So let me show you. You could already see I have replaced the windscreen in here on the bike. So I use this windscreen for my Kanyakumari ride, Bangalore Kanyakumari ride, and in midway of the ride I had to remove this windscreen because it was creating so much of trouble at high speeds. So I couldn't maintain high speeds. The engine was feeling stressed, and I also saw a drop in mileage, and the handle used to feel heavy. The front end used to feel heavy, so which was no way comfortable, riding it. So after coming back, I got it changed. So the windscreen which I've installed is this. You could see the difference here. This is much broader, much wider than what I have here behind the bike. To say, this windscreen is at least little bit aerodynamic with the kind of shape it has, so it's not going to create that much of resistance as the carbon racing windshield did. Like I said, it would be a wiser decision to invest on a good helmet which would reduce the wind buffeting noise and which will also help you on the safety front. So this is the windscreen which I have installed. You see, it's a custom screen. This carbon racing windscreen, so this carbon racing windscreen used to sit at this angle. So it used to sit at this angle and it used to be straight. The carbon racing windscreen sits only on the top level. You can't adjust the carbon racing windscreen to the first level. It always sits on the top level. So you could see the difference in the height and also the difference in the width. So my conclusion about this windscreen is, yes, definitely it's a very, very good design, but not for smaller capacity bikes. So it's good for higher capacity bikes which have good amount of torque, where the difference is not felt at higher speeds. So this is my conclusion on the carbon racing windscreen. So that's it. See you in the next video.